Hi, welcome to Selenium to learn how to read the test data from the CSV files. Okay, in my previous lesson you have learned
how to read the data from Excel files, and in previous lesson you have learned how to write test case whether it is a pass or fail in a Excel file. Okay, today we are going to learn how to read the test data from CSV file. Okay. So I'm using open CSV jar file, which is a plugin. So with the help of open CSV you can read the all data from the CSV files. So whatever the test data you have mentioned, everything you can get from this open CSV. And so what is this open CSV actually, and how you can download this open CSV jar files, and how you will configure this in Eclipse project. And we are creating test data from Excel CSV file, so which is a comma separated file, and passing the test data to input field. Okay, so what is mainly open CSV? Open CSV means it is a simple comma separated values file which is prepared by open CSV, that is a library for Java. So most of the Java people are using this open CSV. Okay, so we have to read the data from the CSV files. Okay, so what is open CSV? CSV means a simple CSV file which is a comma separated values, which is a Java library file. Okay, if you have seen here, this will give you, it is a library for a Java. Okay, it was developed because of all current CSV purchases which is commercial, don't have commercial friendly licenses. Okay, and what is the second one? So we need to download the CSV file, right? So what are the CSV file jar file we need to download? Okay, so when coming to any jar file you want to download, just go to, just type this Maven repository, just go to here. So every details you will get from here. Okay, just click on enter, open CSV and search. So it is showing this one, the exact name you need to enter. See, it is giving open CSV, you can download from source force and you can download from open CSV. Just click on this one. See, these are the versions are released, 3.1, 3.2, 3.3, 4, so up to 3.9, presently it is a 3.9, so most of the users are using this 3.8. okay, this is released in January 2017, okay, you will get a CSV library, CSV tablets, Apache 2.0 license under, so I have downloaded this one, okay, and we need to configure the build, and just click on right click, go to build path, configure build path, this external jars. See, I have downloaded 3.8, I have downloaded in the zip files. Okay, jar files 3.8. okay, just click on open, click on OK. We just refresh, just clean your project once. Okay, and I have created one class, that is a CSV data read, and we need to create the CSV file, right? So I have already created test data dash CSV, this one. I've created sample data which is having one row. Okay, and we need to pass the test data to input field, right? So if you have seen here, not this one, so I will show you. If you have seen my, I want to pass the data like in my contacts form, you will see this is my website, that is regarding load runner. You want to use, you can use, you can read. See here, I want to pass name, email and message. Okay, here I want to pass name, email and message. Okay, just now let's start. have created open browser and CSV file is path I have mentioned. Test.CSV and base URL I have mentioned. Webdriver. Okay. So I have created new Firefox Drawer. Before class it will run. So when coming to test, so CSV file you can read using CSV reader class. Okay. Just click on control space. We'll show you CSV reader. See com.opencsv. Center reader equal to new CSV reader. Okay. Now I want to read this CSV file, right? So for this one, new. File reader. Okay, it will give you the Java IO file reader options. Okay, you need to select this one. Now you have to enter the CSV file. So now it will give you the error like add throws declaration, file not found exception. Okay, we need to verify right every time. Now what you have to do, so we are having, it is a cells, it is a 0, it will count 0, it will 1 and it will 2. So we don't have any header, so we don't need to any write for header. Okay, just save those string. Okay, I want to cell, I have saving into string array, whatever data I have given in a CSV, I want to save in that in string array. Okay. Now what we have to do, we have to use while condition. Why I am using while condition means, let me tell you. So if it is cell, so what I am to verify whether this cell is in means null or not. If it is having empty data, it is having data or empty. Okay, so like this you can use the CSV reader that it will get the data, read next. Okay, I'm not using any list read all, I'm just using read next. If you are using read all, you have to use list. Okay, I'm using string, so I need to verify it should not be null, then only you can pass the data. If it is null, so it's not get the data from the CSV file. Okay, I'm saying it is not null. Okay, you know, I need to add through the declaration input IO Java IO exception. It will see CSV reader is imported and file not found exception is also imported. This file reader exception IO exception also imported, right? Now what I have to do, I need to use the data, this data to pass. So I want to use for loop now. For int I equal to 0. Why? Because it will start from 0, 1, 2. So total row is only one row. Okay. So I less than. So I don't want to take any value here. It is a default is a one row. Okay. So I'm taking 1. So I plus. Yes, you have to enter here. So if you have multiple data, okay, then you need to mention the length path. You have to use cell dot is giving the length. What it will do? So it is giving length. So I am using only one path, right? As a default, I am taking one. So now what I have to do? I have to save this each record, this data into the one cell. One string variable. Okay, string, it is a name equal to, so here I am using cell of I red. Why? Because I will start from 0, so I need to use cell. Next one I am entering email equal to cell of. Now what I have to do here, it will see this is a 0, this is a 1, this is 2, so I need to use I plus 1. I need to use string message equal to cell of i+2. I am using i+1, i+2 means the i equal to 0. Okay, i equal to 0, it will come 0. 0+1, it will give you this data, and 0+2 is 2, it is give you this data. Okay, now I am going to pass the data to here. Just go to here, just insert element, it will give you the Java located. If you have installed Webdriver located in Firefox, it will give you each and every details. So content form names, it is having, let me click on this one. Just click this one and click here. So it is having ID. So I want to use ID. Driver dot find element by ID. What is the ID it is giving? Okay. Send keys. This one I want to use name. So now I want to write for email. Okay, let's go to here. Just click on this one and select. It is giving the ID by ID dot send keys. But it is giving email, right? Now let's go to here. Driver dot find element by ID. Just go to here. I want use for message, this message, that is the text area, it is having ID. Just take this ID and enter here dot send keys. I want to pass this message. Okay, now I want to click for why I think it is ID or something. Let me check for, I need to click for submit, right? Is having ID. Dot. Something is missing. Dot. Click. Okay, this one is done, right? So I'm using this data, which is to pass the data to our here name, email and message. Okay, now I'm using for loop, right? You understood, cell of 0 means it will take this one, cell of 1 means here, cell of 2 here it will take. Okay, so okay, I'm running the file, running the class name as a test engine. I'm using test engine. Now let's see what will happen. It will open the browser. Sorry, I have not used this one. Sorry, not used driver dot get. So that's why it was not opening. Let me run this one more time. Now it will open. Maximize, it will open my URL. It will enter the data. Enter right, message sent successfully. So like this you can use your data, which is a verify search is pass. Okay, see, like this you can use test, pass the test data from the CSV files. Okay, and in next lesson we will see how to generate HTML reports in Selenium script for each and every test cases. Okay. Thank you for watching my video. Please subscribe to my videos and please provide your valuable comments on this video in the form of comments. Please provide your suggestions also. Okay, thank you.